around about 10 years ago, just as the boom of DVD was starting to come down, many supermarkets started stocking very, very cheap DVDs. We're talking about 2007, 2008. Specifically, Tesco was one I kind of frequented at the time. And there was a specific brand that I saw a lot, and that was this brand here, which is Grabit. They mainly did DVDs, but when they started putting those out, they started putting out some Sega PC games, which were kind of strange to see. You didn't see these for very, very long. I mean, these came out sort of, especially Sega Rally was, you know, late 90s. It was after the Sega Saturn version. They all kind of looked like this. They all came in as like a slimline DVD case, all single disc. But yeah, these were £1, which is pretty cheap, and for DVDs they were pretty cheap. I mean, most of the stuff you got on DVD was direct-to-video guff, like real terrible. I mean, the only thing I ever got from this range of DVDs was the Kentucky Fried movie, which again is like a budget release, but at least a good one. I've played plenty of bad ones. But you kind of compare what a traditional PC game of that time would have been. I mean, we were almost at the point where getting games on discs was null and void 10 years ago, so, you know, Steam wasn't quite what it is now, but, you know, you would expect a nice chunky DVD case with a manual in it. We'll get to that one later. But the reason I bring this up, and the whole reason I even bothered to get a camera out, is I bought this about 10 years ago, and I've done nothing with it. And there was one reason I bought it. It was one of the games in this pack. So this is a 10 great PC games, as we can see up above the top of the box, pack. As you can probably see, there's not 10 DVD cases in here. And as you can also probably see, some of these aren't Sega games, and we'll get onto those in a bit. I can't remember how much this cost me. I don't think it was £10. If it was £10, I deserve to be shot for buying this. Because most of these are budget re-releases of games that have been around for years. So look at the back. We've kind of got, I don't know how much you're going to be able to make those out, but we'll go through the games one by one. As you can see, you've got 5 Sega games down here: Sega Rally, Sega Worldwide Soccer, Sonic R, Virtual Fighter, which were all Sega Saturn ports, as far as I'm aware, and House of the Dead 2, which is an early Dreamcast game, and clearly the most advanced of the bunch. And we've got 5 more games down here, ones I've never come across: Archangel, or Archangel, whichever you'd like, Dual Shooter, Zing Omaha Hold'em Poker, The Legend of Luwa, and Dragon X Gold Quest. So I've got an XP PC, unbelievably, mainly for this, but again, we'll get onto that later. I figured we would run through this and see how many of these I can actually get to work. So Sega Rally is the first game on the list. Installed it, DirectX 3. If we look at the back, it says it's compatible with XP in 2000. As you can see from the specs, it expects a 90 megahertz processor, which is probably a little bit taxing for my i7 2.8 gigahertz, whatever it is, 2600K, 16 megs of RAM, 40 mega hard drive space, 4 meg of graphics card, and it's a 2-speed CD-ROM, which I'm fairly sure this is a DVD drive, so we're nowhere near that. It also, interestingly, some of these have XP compatibility notices, which I'm guessing means that if you went to that website originally, I'm guessing this website doesn't exist anymore, it would tell you to run the game in Windows 95 mode instead of XP. So this is Sega Rally, or Sega Rally Championship. This game's really good. The Sega Saturn version is brilliant. The PC version, if I remember rightly, was pretty good. What I will say is, this is definitely a PC port from the 90s. If we press F3, we can come out to this lovely menu. And the thing I want to do in here is change controls, because it wants me to accelerate and brake with the numpad. And I think I would actually prefer to do X and Z. Up, down, left, and right. Yeah, I think we can handle that. Let's just restart game. See what happens.
And then pause. Sega Rally Championship.
So 97 is the copyright on this, so I guess this was a little bit later than the Sega Saturn version, which I think would have been 96? Maybe it was 97. Let's just jump in. Championship. There's only one car to choose, and that is that one. Let's see how quickly this loads on a 2011 PC. I'm hoping this isn't going to be a complete nightmare. I will say, I've had to... yeah, that's what I'm worried about. I booted this game up and it was essentially doing very fast, very slow, very fast, very slow. I tried putting compatibility mode on. That doesn't seem to have helped. So now I have an unplayable version of Sega Rally, which is good. I'll point out, all these games say they're compatible with XP. I haven't checked the XP compatibility notice on the Empire Interactive website, because that website doesn't exist anymore. This is pretty unplayable though. It's like it's trying to do 30 frames a second, but it's doing 20 of them really quickly and then 10 of them really slowly. Improper frame pacing, as we might say in this day and age. Oh, am I going to make it to the end of the race? This is gut-wrenching stuff. Am I even going to be facing the right way by the end of the race? Elephant! So maybe this isn't the way I would want to play this game. This is actually one of those ones that I don't know why Sega haven't gone and reported it. Because, you know, that Xbox Live Arcade version of Daytona USA was really good. And Sega Rally Online Arcade was pretty good as well. So what's the problem with these games where you've got three courses is they've got quite a limited amount of appeal outside of nerds like me who love the original Sega Rally. But I'd love a properly cleaned up version of this. This and maybe Sega Touring Car, because the Saturn version of that was a train wreck. I'm not going to make it to the checkpoint. It's around this corner, I think. Oh. Nope. But I get to hear the awesome music. Oh yes. That's what we're here for. The game over, yeah. Okay, that doesn't seem to work. The other thing you can do is just go in here and play with the sound settings. Which means you can listen to Ignition. This is what I really want to do, be honest. I'll sit and listen to the Sega Rally soundtrack all day. Or we could just listen to...
Turn around, over jump, two, whoa!
Where's Easy Right Maybe anyway? Oh, that's some Sega menu sounds. Almost sounds like Resident Evil, actually.
Sega Rally Championship!
Brilliant. I'm guessing also, because these are PC versions of the Sega Saturn version, I can come and listen to the soundtrack. Yes! It's all just CD audio. Because it was the cheapest way of shipping that sort of music around.
Sega Worldwide Soccer PC, which I believe is a port of Sega Worldwide Soccer 97 for the Saturn, which is a game I own and actually I do quite enjoy. I think at the time there was a lot of kind of infighting about what the best football game was on the PlayStation. And actually, the Sega Saturn people had it pretty well. I mean, it wasn't particularly licensed. And FIFA did come out on the Sega Saturn, but I think only 97. But it's not that bad a game. I don't know how the PC version holds up, though. This one specifically says not 2000. So this is slightly higher, 90 MHz processor, 8 MB of RAM, 16 MB of graphics card. It wants a bigger graphics card than system memory. That's interesting.
So Sega Worldwide Soccer seems to be a problem in that I just keep getting this error over and over again. Let's try some compatibility mode on it and see if that works. Hey! So compatibility mode works with it. Now we get this awesome Japanese shred guitar music. So I can tell you, as somebody who's played Sega Worldwide Soccer 97 recently, for whatever reason, this is exactly that. This intro movie is the same music. Ah, the CG. That guy just have a t-shirt just says pizza.
don't know about you, this gets the passion of mid-90s football, or soccer, and Brazil flags. Oh yeah, I guess this is worldwide, so it's going to be world teams. A lot of kicking on the ground. From what I remember, you can't do that in the game, so this cutscene is grossly misleading. Yeah, shred guitar. Press enter key.
Please select a mode.
Some flickering, but I don't know if that's just my monitor or if that's the game. And I can't get to the... Do I have to click? There we go. Device setting. Oh, Jesus. ZXC, SD, Shift, Control, A and S. Oh, okay. We'll see how that goes. Pitch. High detail, obviously. Edited data. Chat. Interesting. Oh, okay. Well, this is a shame. They've put all these extra settings in. But, it means I can... turn off fouls and injuries. Ooh. Excellent. A lot of options. It's just, I thought I said fire then. Just as fine. Unfortunately, it'd be nice if these were actually included in the game rather than as this horrible. But that was just, you know, that was the game at the time. Ooh. 16-bit colour. All sorts of options. Sound setting. I could pick CD audio instead of live announcement. Alright, let's mess around and actually play the game.
Exhibition.
1P versus Com, so I guess I have to be England. Let's play against... let's pick an interesting one. Japan. This game was made in Japan. Stadium. Oh, this has got the same problem. It's got that weird jumping frame rate issue.
Tonight's game is England versus Japan.
Yep, let's go. Let's see if this works.
Hello everyone, I'm delighted to be with you for tonight's game. And hopefully both teams can contribute to an entertaining
This
evening.
Doesn't look very good.
So let's see the outcome here between England and Japan. Now it's down to business. The referee blows his whistle for the beginning of the first half.
Oh, I got the ball.
Here comes the counter thrust, and he's not afraid to take players on.
No, I've given the ball away.
And it goes straight up the field.
This is quite impossible to play. I'm going to go out on a limb and say this doesn't work on Windows XP.
This is Virtua Fighter PC, which is a port of the first Virtua Fighter game. Again, this came out a long while ago on the PC specifically. This one's a slightly chunkier amount of system resources. It wants a 133 MHz processor, 140 MB disk space, 32 megs of memory.
So this is Virtua Fighter, or as the box occasionally says, Virtual Fighter. And you can tell the quality of this port because it says press start button on a system where you don't have a controller. Ooh, and I've got a cursor. Do I have any options? Doesn't look like it. Sound test. Oh. How do I make the sound go? I don't know how I'm doing that. Which of the keys on this keyboard presses does the music test? Whoa. What did I just press X, Y, and Z button. Doesn't do anything. Well, guess we're not doing that. I usually easily play Sarah in Virtua Fighter, not that I'm good at it. Oh, wait, second player. Wait, does second player not enter? Yeah, this would be much easier if I knew what the keys were.
Fight one,
ready, go!
Oh, here we go. Same problem, as expected. And I appear to be player two. Have I entered? Am I controlling both these characters, or am I just controlling the one on the right? Why am I the second player? Why is it frozen? So F3 still pauses, but it doesn't take you out to the little menu. Okay, so F7 is restart, I think. I'm confused. Watch mode.
Fight one, ready, go!
Alright, I can watch somebody else fight. This seems better with the frame rate, but still not brilliant. So far, not particularly impressed. I don't know whether these were pre-XP Server Pack 3, maybe? Maybe that's what's causing the issue, but still.
Sonic R, another Sega Saturn port. This, I don't know where this box art came from. I don't know if this is the Japanese box art, because I've never seen it before. Maybe this is the PC art box art. I don't know. Certainly doesn't look anything like the PAL Saturn vert release. I don't know if you've ever seen the title screen for Sonic R, but it's not supposed to look like that. This also said press start button. I was about to tell you this game doesn't work, but I found a little thing on the internet that says if you hold the enter button on the executable, it'll eventually work. Which seemed insane, and then it actually worked. That being said, I don't think Direct3D is maybe the version I should have gone for, because it seems like Direct3D is not happy. Ooh, there's a graphics option. Hang on, resolution. I can't do anything with resolution. I thought I was going to say windowed. I could just make the window smaller. Oh, Christ. Okay. Can I do music test? I can, so I don't need the game to work. Oh, I can turn the vocals and the music off. Alright, I'm into this. Let's just see if I boot the game. Let's just see what it looks like before I go out and turn it to the other mode, because I'm curious. Because this already looks awesome, with these blinking backgrounds. And random garbage appearing on the screen. Oh!
Ready, set,
okay, it just go. Seems to be... The bitmap graphics seems to be struggling then, because the actual rendering looks fine. Weird. Okay. That's for me laughing at this game. Oh, you missed the vocals though, don't you? I was also reading. So most of these games I've gone and Googled information about. Very little out there. This game, plenty. Like, oh, you want to play it at 1080p? There's this fix. You want to fix the application error problem that I was experiencing? Oh, there's this patched file. Try this, try that. Yep, that's Sonic R for you. It's got lots of fans. It's a Sonic product. I definitely played this as a kid, but it's not a good game. It certainly hasn't held up particularly well. Not that I'm showing that by collecting all the coins in this first level. I think at the time you were just desperate for anything on the Sega Saturn that was worth playing. Especially if you were looking for a Sonic game, like there wasn't, you didn't have a lot of choice. You play Sonic 3D if you really hated yourself. And that's one thing I'm grateful for, is this pack doesn't have Sonic 3D in it, so I don't have to play that damn game again. More coins. The black line down the screen is a bit annoying. And the occasional flickering texture. But to be honest, at least this doesn't have the flickery frame rate issue that the other Saturn games have had. That was irritating. This is, I can put up with this. Yeah, take that, Knuckles. I'm going to beat you. I know all the hot shortcuts. Oh, God. This. Where? Is that flickering between Japanese and... Oh, is it just random sprites? I apologize if this is hurting your eyes. Maybe I should put a strobe warning on this, because this looks awful. Let's try the other mode. Right. Direct draw. This seems happier. This looks a lot better already. Yeah, there we go. I'll press the start button, which happens to be the enter key. God, these menus. Can I mean I can turn the graphics up? No, still can't turn the graphics up. Oh, I could turn interlacing on, though. For whatever reason, I would do that. I can't even press up to go on the other side of the menu. I wanted to turn vocals back on again. No! Jesus. Almost. Do a different track. Show this game as it's supposed to be. You wait, I'll do this now and the frame rate problem will be back. Oh, this looks alright. Weird. Ready, reflective water.
Set. Go!
Yeah, a weird kind of mirage effect in the background's a bit odd, but... Again, it's playable. That is better than I can say for the other three games I've tried so far. Yeah, those vocals are back. That Richard Jack soundtrack. I will say, these PC versions are great for getting the soundtracks, because they still use the same Redbook audio that the Sega Saturn version used, so you can just put it into your computer and rip it like you would a CD. That is, if your computer still has a CD drive, but I realise how insane that sounds. Have one of them their fancy MacBooks. Okay, this seems fine. This seems playable. Can I go down there? So far we've got one working game. That's a bit disappointing for a 10 great games. I can't even call classics like Sega Rally great because they don't work. Yeah, my only assumption is that they worked at the time. Or at least I hope they did. You never know with these budget re-releases. Miles away from the track. This soundtrack. It's majestic. Chaos Emerald. Sonic's gonna lead. I need to change that. This game's weird because it's kind of like Mario Kart, but there's not really any power-ups. You're not shooting things at people. Ah, take that, Sonic. I have more rings. Alright, I could literally sit here and play this all day, so let's not do that. Let's move on.
House of the Dead 2. This is the most advanced game in the box set. This was a Dreamcast game, and I think the PC version came out at around about the same time. And I remember the PC version being particularly good. As you might expect, the specs are a lot higher for this. So they were expecting a Pentium 2 of all things, and half a gig of disk space, which probably was a lot at the time. Also doesn't support Windows 2000, which just seems like a shame.
Shoot outside of the screen!
The House of the Dead.
So this is probably the best thing in the pack, to be honest. Just double check. Arcade mode. House of the Dead 2 is a great game. The voice acting is unbelievable.
Over there.
But in terms of light gun shooters, I really enjoyed this game. And it still kind of holds up. I picked the Wii version up not long ago, played it over Christmas, and it's still pretty good. It's still difficult. I was never particularly good at these games, but playing with a mouse, it still kind of holds up. I'm sure if you went and emulated the arcade version, it would look better than this, but hey, that's, you know, that's emulation for you, isn't it? Oh, missed him. But in terms of emulation and, you know, quality of port, this is miles above everything else. This looks like an actual game. You can almost put this out on Steam.
I don't want to die.
My God.
My God. Gotta shoot the things.
Help him. Don't kill him. No.
Oh, there's crates in the background. I missed.
You can get outside that way.
This game's a nightmare. It gives you so little time to actually, there you go, to get those types of pickups.
Thank you for rescuing me.
Yeah, don't give me health then. Greedy. Oh, not the little wormy things. Ooh.
Gee, blood stains.
Come on. I've played the first level of this game so many times. Like I say, it doesn't mean I'm good at it. But I know roughly where the enemies are coming from. That's the problem with doing a recording with a microphone right next to a mouse, is I imagine all you can hear is clicking. I rescued you. I rescued you. Use your words.
Thank you. Please take this.
Am I actually going to get to the boss? That smoke doesn't look very right. Or maybe the straight line with the glitching at the top. I didn't know if it was supposed to be there. Oh, good. It went off the screen. I can forget about that weird effect. Weak points the little dude. Oh, this is, I don't think I'm going to get through this without losing a life. Just a hunch. These Sega arcade games were always brutal. Clearly built to get your money out of you. This is the bit. What is this? Circled. Alright, that's the end of the Sega stuff, unfortunately. If this was a 10 pack of Sega games that actually worked, I'd be way into it, but I need to check this extra disc out with 5 other games that I've never played.
James, go and prevent the confusion in the city.
So this is the interesting one. This is the other 5 games in this 10-game pack. This seems to be a grab bag of all sorts of weird and wonderful games. If we look at the back of the case, you can see you don't actually get descriptions of any of the games. You just get spec sheets. All of them support XP, apparently. Some of them even support Windows 95, which is kind of impressive. So I'm wondering how old these games are.
So first up is Archangel, The Legacy of Peace. Does it say who made this game? It doesn't. First Holo training. Welcome to the Holo Zone. Okay. Locked past doors. Locked past doors. And security doors are present. Locate keys. Locked past doors. exits of superior missions, and they appear as brightly coloured squares or rings. Alright. Oh, Jesus Christ. Auto-equip, please. Okay. I think I know what I'm doing. Oh, right. I have to right-click them. It's a nice high-res CD, though. I like that. Click to continue. Oh, wow. It's like the world's most basic Crusader. Oh, I'm off the screen. Nine of action points. Oh, okay, so it's an XCOM style thing then. Right. So how do I end my turn? Okay, I can save the game. That over there. Pick it up. Oh, Jesus Christ. Do I have to use one of these? Nope, that's not useful. Okay. I can crouch. That uses action points. How do I? God, even turning around uses action points. What is that grey thing? What if I have to crouch down and then... maybe it's nothing. Just turn glass walls on? No. How do I get through that door? Oh, I'll leave him there. Let's go. So that's the thing there. Could be able to click it, surely. Select use. How do I select use? Oh, floor. Oh, Jesus. All right, switch the other guy. Floor. Pass key. And now I'm guessing I can use that on the door. Yay! Oh, you gotta run. So I'm going to lose the will to live. Oh. Whoop. Get too click happy. Why don't you come out here? So what's the overriding objective? Go down there? And does each character have its own set of action points? Or is it shared? Because, yeah, I'm going to say, something like an XCOM, you'd expect everyone to have their own set of action points. It won't let you scroll when it's moving, which is unfortunate. So now I've got the pass. Does that mean I can use that here? Yes, I can. I'm the world's greatest Archangel player. I used on that door? No. Gotta go through that. Floor. Security key. Seems very finicky about. Oh, is it actually going to let me go as far as. No, it won't. That's weird. Oh, an enemy! Oh, here we go. This is getting proper tense now. Go down here. Shoot that man. How do I shoot? Do I use my pack? And oh Jesus, this guy hasn't got any guns. Use your fists, man. Oh Jesus. And this guy's gonna be nowhere near. Get your running shoes on, sir. I've still got 10 points. I should be able to get in the vicinity. I want to throw this holo grenade at him. But I've got not. I ain't got enough points to do it. Right, you get out of the way. You get in there. And you throw that holo grenade at that man. Yes! Proceed to exit the disco light room. Get in there. You follow. He's got a gun in his hand, I've just realised. Where's his gun? Mission completed! Could use some music. Wait, what? Oh, okay. I was gonna say that's not the end of the game, surely. Basic holo training. That's enough Archangel, let's move on to the next one. Unfortunately, no matter what I tried, dual shooter doesn't seem to work, which is unfortunate because that's the one that wanted the 1 GHz processor and seemed to support XP. And was DirectX 9, so I assumed this one was going to work. But not even compatibility mode will bring this one back from the dead. So this is Zing Omaha Hold'em Poker. It doesn't look particularly great on this screen. I guess because it's just stretching out to whatever resolution you want to use. You can set different table back textures, like table 2, which looks kind of like skin of a snake. I quite like the tiger print cards. They're classy. Let's stick with those. Let's up the ante a little bit. Player setup. Oh, I can make him silly. Yes. Everyone is silly. Might change icon. Oh, it's just a bunch of JPEGs. Okay. Let's hang on. Okay. Let's do call. Turn. So this one I should mention was like 5 MB to install. And it kind of looks like it too. What have I got? I've got a pair of threes. P- pair of... Well, got two pair, actually. Well, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just keep on calling. Oh, Roy. That's gone badly for me. Wait, if I hit new game, it'll give me all that money. Yeah, there you go. 28,000. Okay, pair of sevens. I'm going with a pair of sevens. Three of a kind. Let's raise. Let's live dangerously. See how badly this goes for me. Pair of aces. I've got to win that, surely. Player wins! How much do I win? An amount of money. Yeah, that's poker. I don't think we need to spend any more time on that. Oh, I just got a pair of aces, though. Let's see how high I can get this bet. Let's raise. Cool. Ace, 2, 3, 4. 5. I got a straight flush. I ain't backing down, son. Wait. Roy wins with flush. Ace, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ace, 2, 3, 4, 5. This game's stupid. This game was a challenge to find. It didn't even install a start menu icon. Legend of Luwa. Ah, from Zing again. I assume that's Zing, not Xing. Okay. All right. Oh. There's one thing I love. It's Comic Sans font. Oh, it's like a top-down RPG. And this looping nutcracker. Is this Nutcracker or is this Swan Lake? Swan Lake, isn't it? All right. I'm wandering around. There's a dude. Let's go speak to the dude. You cannot go out barehanded. I agree. That loop. Savage. Yep, okay, so Green Angel's missing. We're very sad about this. What's in the kitchen? Oh, no. No, I don't want to talk to you. Chicken. That chicken hurt my heart, my health. All these buildings look the same. You must have bolus hulu to hold my med bolus. Do you understand anything about that sentence? Because I don't. What? Is that Chinese? as a well. My son is taken away by the big monkey. This must be like a Chinese mythical story, right? It's an empty house. So where do I get a weapon from? That's my house. Oh, I didn't go in that one. Want to buy darts? I'm indifferent about darts, if I'm honest. Take a rest and cure your wound. Oh, can I take the sword off the... No. I'll buy a torch. What a strange thing to put in a bundle of games. Well, they must have translated this. Unless they it was already translated and they just bought it. I don't know. What a strange thing to end up in a pack like this. Is this a budget re-release in China, or...? There are three things you must keep in mind when playing this game. Talk to people, check the map, save the progress. There's a map? Oh! Dearie me. No gamepad. Oh man, I could have plugged in a gamepad. Oh. I could turn the music off. Or turn it back on again. Alright. I'm confused about everything that's happening here.
Yeehaw.
I appreciate your courage. Take this bolus hulu. Hey! Now I can go see that guy who was talking about med bolus. I can't remember which building he was in, though. Was it this one? What's that? The wise old man in the village. But he does not want to live in the village. He lives in the North Woods instead. It was the angry guy, wasn't it? That was the other building. It was one of the first buildings I went in. It wasn't this one. Well, who knew? Who knew I was sitting on this gem for ages? Ah, he could give me a weapon. No, he just wants to talk about his son. Is it in here? No. Oh! Okay, so I can now buy healing. I'm guessing now, do I have a weapon? Can I equip it? Nope. Well, I'm gonna be entirely honest. Oh, hang on. Maybe, let's see if this guy can shed a light on what's going on. Yes. I got the practice sword. Let's get the sword out. Where's the? Oh, it's already attached.
Hey.
Whoop.
Hey.
So D is attack. Can I attack the chicken?
Hey.
No. I want to attack at least something before we start playing this. That? Is that an enemy? Okay. when you pick up a coin, it kind of sounds like the ding noise in Windows. All right. Well, that's Legend of Luwa. I'm confused. So I was all ready to end on a bang and show off Dragon X Gold Quest, but again, this game doesn't seem to work. I don't think this has been shipped with the DLLs it needs to actually run. But I might be wrong. This is a multimedia fusion game, which if you've ever played like the Sonic fan games from about 10 years ago, it was a kind of 2D game engine, kind of similar to Game Maker, I guess. But slightly... Well, hang on, multimedia fusion. Yeah, I definitely played a bunch of Sonic fan games at the time, because this was back when, you know, you couldn't download games from Steam. So, you take what you get, but again, DLL missing. I'm sure I could probably track down the DLL, but I kind of don't want to go down downloading random DLLs to try and make this work. Just enjoy the music, which is all in MP3 form. And the fact that a multimedia fusion game was actually sold. The interesting thing is, when you install this, the installer has the unregistered free version of the installer, so it's interesting. It was available for purchase, though, and it also appears to be in Dutch, so it must have come from the Netherlands. But yeah, that's the Game Mania pack. One of these other levels. Bonus was... Oh, which one was good? Appears to be real music as well. I don't know. Interesting. Yeah, that's the Game Mania pack. Slightly disappointing that most of those games don't seem to work, even though I've gone to the trouble of making sure I'm running under XP, not Windows 10. Basically, I just resulted in us playing Sonic R, House of the Dead, and that Chinese RPG. But yeah, that's a weird thing that I can now get rid of, because I feel like I have used it.